without a doubt.
What an elegant surrender. And put up more posters. I can't believe I have to say that to you people.
Well, apparently, if we get 100% participation, which media will do its best to aid, they're going to put us in the Times. I booked a photographer just in case.
Good.
NBC's having the Mitch Miller concert on Thursday. Any chance I could show you and Mrs. Draper off?
We'd love to, but my kid is sick. You know what that means soon enough.
Shut down.
That was quick.
What do we have today?
The 10 o'clock with Miss Holloway to go over traffic for new business. 4 o'clock with Ron Benincasa from Ace Hardware, and Mr. Sterling moved the meeting with Boston Edison to 5.
I assume to have it bleed into the cocktail hour.
May I? There was a bit of confusion last night. I think I made a terrible mistake.
What happened?
Your daughter called and asked when you would be back from your business trip because her mother wasn't sure. You don't have to tell me anything, but I didn't know what to say. I said Wednesday. I know I should have said I don't know.
Mrs. Draper is working out some things.
I understand. I'm sure it won't come up again.
I thought it would be over by now, I guess, and there'd be no need to.
I'm sorry about that.
It goes without saying that this is personal. And I'd appreciate you keeping it that way.
Of course.
I'd also avoid giving me concerned looks.
Mr. Draper, I hope you've noticed I'm a discreet person.
I don't know you at all, and this is personal, and it's not up for discussion.
Of course. If you need anything, I'm right out there.
I'm at the Roosevelt if there's an emergency.
In an interview just weeks before her death, Miss Monroe angrily protested to a